Hey guys, welcome back to Affinity Racing and another Gran Turismo video where we finally bulk recorded all of these intros, and so I will keep this one very short as well. But Bathurst is a track that, for a start, I absolutely love. One of my favourites, probably up there, I would say, in the top five, but only on a good day, because when you get that downhill section wrong, I don't half hate that track. But this week, it's a little bit different. It's Daily Race B for this week in the Group 3s on Gran Turismo. And one thing that I realised is that with most Daily Race Cs, so the longer form races, the more laps, at a track like Bathurst, you're forced to be a little bit patient. You start to close up, but as you get there on the mountain, you have to give people the space, because if they wreck it, you're going to wreck it as well. But then, when it comes to Daily Race B, that is normally a 5-lap sprint, a 3-lap sprint, certainly no more than 6-7 laps in most cases. And that at Bathurst is a very short amount of time to try and get in front, cut through the grid, get to the front of the pack. And so you have to be really, really wary about who you're racing and how you're racing. But this one went a lot better than I expected. Right then, starting P9. Our best intentions on this one is to move forward up the grid. But it feels like Autopolis gets harder and harder every time. The more you drive, the more you push, the more you crash. Oh, we're going to be starting on this corner again. Brutal, that is. Right, trying the Corvette then. Trying to go different to majority of the group to give ourselves a bit of an advantage. Is it going to work? The M6 as well, look, very, very popular car around here. Right, braking pretty early there. Side by side with Nico here. Never really going to work trying to look for the move on the way up the hill. What a move. Happy with that one. Right, back in front of Nico, the fellow Brit, here. Now, we managed a few overtakes in the previous race. Got up by a couple of positions, hopefully we can do the same here. Braking very early there, so that we didn't go into the back of those guys, but the Portuguese driver puts it into the wall. Right, we've got P6 in front of us here. Oh, we've been hit. We got hit into the wall there, but he's stayed back to make sure we keep the position, so we say fair enough. Is that Forza that has multi-class, do you mean? Because we're still waiting on multi-class for Gran Turismo, but it doesn't look like it's ever going to turn up, no matter how long we wait. Very slow through the first apex there. Smartly done, so that I would either go into the back of him and push him out the corner to help build his gap, or that I just back off altogether. this. No matter how early I am on the throttle, my pace is then dictated by this guy all the way up the hill and across the top here. Or up the mountain, I should say. It's a bit more than a hill. Right, I think we can have it this time round. Right, he backs out of that one. Great race in that though. Right, final lap here. We're just bringing home the P6, I think. There we go. And they all cross the line safely enough. There we have it. P6, not a bad result considering we're in a totally different car there. Although we got Genesis, M6, Supra and an RCF in the top five. So Corvette, five different cars in the top six. Yeah, good race that. How did you get on, Kevin? Oh, you got a podium. P3 for Kevin. Nice one. Kevin did better than us. Great result that. Looked like it was pretty close battles up the top there. 2, 3, 4 and 5. Well, that one was decent, that, and much to my surprise, even though we were awful, we drove awfully on the previous attempt where we binned it plenty in the Supra. Both of those races that we've done for Daily Race B, much, much better than I thought. Beyond expectation, the track dictates that you have to be patient in the race. And so the longer form Daily Race C is amazing for. The manufacturer's race is really good for. I didn't expect it to be that good on Daily Race B, where you only have five laps and everybody's really trying to push their way past, quite literally push their way past in a lot of cases. And so the driving ends up being not that great, but everyone kept it as they should. Great racing all around there, I would say, which you don't often get for Daily Race B. So there is something going on in Gran Turismo, because we had a clean Daily Race A, a clean Daily Race B, and we've had some good Daily Race Cs. So something strange is happening, but there we go.